Hi, I'm Peter Nielsen from Sail Magazine, and we're here at the Annapolis Sailboat Show in 2016 aboard the brand spanking new Catalina 425. Actually, this is hull number 4. It's been a popular boat for Catalina already. It's the 5th boat in their series of Jerry Douglas's 5 series, and it's the kind of evolution of everything that's gone into the other 4 boats that's preceded it, combined with a fair bit of input from Catalina customers who are very brand loyal. This boat has been set up to be sailed easily by a couple. So it has in-mast furling, which comes standard on Catalinas these days. It has a German mainsheet system, or a variant of that, which is led back to the cockpit in 2 places in the cockpit, so it's easy to trim. It has an excellent anchoring system with a double bow roller and a very deep divided anchor locker, so it's laid out for some pretty serious cruising. Self-tacking jib also makes it very easy to sail. And you'll note this lovely sun pad down here, which you can sail with it still tied on. And it folds back so you can open the hatch for ventilation when you're at anchor if you're not actually enjoying a nice gin and tonic on your sun pad. Note the side decks are lovely and clear, shrouds are well inboard, sheet tracks are inboard. It's a very clean and very user-friendly deck layout. So here we are in the cockpit, and I'm enjoying one of its nicest features, which is a little fold-out bed, perfect for sleeping on in harbour. I mean, in a beautiful summer's evening, there's nothing better than lying out here. It's perfectly comfortable. When you want to go sailing, you just get up, you fold the bed away, and off you go. Cockpit is deep, wide. Combings are actually very nicely angled, very nicely proportioned cockpit. All lines are led aft, as you see here. The main sheet is double-ended, so part of it comes to this winch here, and the other part comes to the port side sheet winch. Because the Genoa, or the jib rather, is self-tacking, there's no need for jib sheets to be led aft. There's just a single sheet. So the winches here are for, you'll use them for the spinnaker or the asymmetric sail or a code zero or whatever other light airs, headsail, and downwind sail you want to put on the boat. Very solid, sturdy cockpit table. I was delighted to see has a refrigerator inside it, so there's no reason to cart bags of ice onto the boat. Just fire it up, stock it up, and away you go sailing. The nav pod there holds the multifunction display for navigation between the two pedestals. Sight lines from behind the wheel are excellent all the way around. All in all, very user-friendly cockpit. And don't forget these nice solid rails that go forward. They're a great safety feature, and they're also ideal for hanging solar panels on. And here's another cool feature you've got to check out. This is just no ordinary cockpit locker. It opens up into the aft cabin, and so you can just throw the kids down there when you're underway, and they'll be nice and quiet. You can check on them, and it also serves as a handy escape hatch. So I've just walked down into what's a very well lit and really nicely proportioned saloon. Also typical of Catalina. Lots of good seagoing sense has gone into this boat, because the designer actually goes sailing an awful lot, so he knows what makes a boat practical and nice to live aboard. Good handholds here on either side of the boat, with an easy reach of even short crew members, which is quite important. Really nice C-shaped galley, lots of stowage. There are 2 fridges. 6.9 inches of headroom back here, so that's pretty impressive. And it drops maybe to 6'6" or 6'7" forward, but still ample headroom. Twin aft cabins in this layout. What's special about them is that they are convertible bunks. As you can see in this port side cabin here, one of the leaves is up, so it creates a beautiful little sea berth here with lots of stowage beside it. So you can have both cabins configured that way, or you can drop the leaves and have 2 double berths back there, depending on who you're sailing with, which is a very useful thing. There's a little nav desk over here to starboard, 2 seats. This dinette is very functional. Of course, the table drops to form a double berth. All the weight, tankage, and everything is concentrated towards the middle of the boat here.
to keep weight centralized and minimize pitching, which makes for a more comfortable ride at sea. It's a very functional and very actually spacious interior. So the Catalina 425, I think, is a great all-round cruiser. It sails well, it's well built, there's lots of nice details on it. It's easy to handle and it's roomy and spacious and it's very hard to fault. I think it'd be a great boat for a young family or a couple who just want to do any kind of cruising whatsoever, whether it's across an ocean or along a coastline. It'd be a good boat.